So today we'll be discussing about a derivation which asks us to derive an expression for the optimal pressure ratio for the maximum power output. It means that what should be the pressure ratio, optimal pressure ratio, so that your power output from your gas turbine is maximum. So even here, sometimes we'll be specifying as below also derive an expression for work output of a gas turbine in terms of pressure ratio, which is beta, for maximum and minimum temperature T3 and T1. Hence show that the pressure ratio for the maximum specific work output is given by beta optimal, which is optimal pressure ratio, that is equal to T3 by T1 whole raised to the power of Y divided by 2 into gamma minus 1. That is not Y, that is gamma. Now, this is, remember, he has asked it for ideal Brayton cycle. If he is asking for the ideal Brayton cycle, you are supposed to derive in this manner. If he is asking for the actual Brayton cycle, this is the another derivation, then you can do it in the next video. Okay. For the actual, this one, ideal Brayton cycle, just write down the PV diagram and TS diagram of a actual Brayton cycle. So, you know that the work net is the summation of the turbine work, which is from 3 to 4, and the compressive work from 1 to 2. That is, work net is given as WT plus WC. I already told you in the previous video that you are supposed to calculate the work done in this manner itself. It is MCP delta T, that 2, delta T being initial minus final. So MCP for the turbine, initial state is T3 and final state is T4. Similarly for the compressor, initial state is T1 minus in final state is T2. After that you can take MCP as common, remaining expression is here. Now when you consider for the unit mass, you can eliminate the mass here, so it would be CP into T3 minus T2. And remember, so your T1 minus T2, I can interchange it to T2 minus T1, so it adds negativity here and it continues further. So in this particular expression, what I am doing is, in these two expressions, I have taken T3 as common. If I take T3 as common, nothing here, the T3 get cancels, so 1 remains, so T4 divided by T3 here. So if I take T1 common here, what happens? T2 divided by T1 and T1 goes away, so it is 1. So by the definition of the temperature ratio, we have TR is equals to T2 by T1, this equals to T3 by T4 as discussed in the previous derivation, right? Now, so the previous expression was this, and we have defined the temperature ratio as T2 by T1 is equals to T3 by T4. Now substituting the things, now T3 by T4 is TR, so T4 by T3 is 1 by TR. Similarly, substituting T2 by T1 as TR. 1 by TR, if it goes in the numerator, it is TR to the power of minus 1. So now, this is very important. What is the condition so that your output from the turbine is maximum? This is the condition for the maximum specific power output is given by the differentiation of total work done with respect to TR must be equal to 0. That is D divided by DTR into the work net must be equal to 0. Substituting the work net from this equation 1. So here it is. So CP being the constant term, remember you are supposed to differentiate only with respect to TR here. Okay, so all the other things will be treated as a constant, correct? So CP is a constant, you can take it outside, and T3 is also constant, you can take it outside. Differentiation of 1 is 0, and TR whole to the power of minus 1, n into x to the power of n minus 1, is it? So minus 1 into TR to the power of minus 2 minus T1 into, again it is a constant, so TR differentiation is 1 and 1 differentiation, constant differentiation is 0. What happens, you can transfer this CP to the other side, so it becomes 0. So you'll be left out with T3 into TR whole to the power of minus 2 minus T1. So TR whole to the power of minus 2 is equals to T1 divided by TR. So see, this particular TR is obtained by applying the condition of maximum specific power output, correct? So that's why this particular TR is optimal TR, for which the maximum specific work output is obtained. correct? So now T1 by TR, TR optimal is equals to T3 by T1. If you just reciprocate, it eliminates the negativity here. T3 by T1 is equals, if you transfer the 2 to the other side, it is 1 by 2. Correct? Now, listen here. So, T3 by T1 is what? TR again. But remember, there is a difference. This is just a TR, which is of the particular process. And this is TR optimal, where you will get the maximum specific hour output. Okay? In the previous derivation, we have even shown that TR is equals to beta whole to the power of gamma divided by gamma minus 1. Correct? So, if I take TR as optimal, even beta would be optimal. If TR is optimal, beta would be optimal. So TR optimal is equals to beta optimal whole to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So what I am doing is, I am replacing TR optimal with beta optimal whole to the power of gamma divided by gamma minus 1 by this expression. After that, I am replacing T3 by T1 as TR. So if I transfer gamma minus 1 by gamma to the other side, what happens? It is gamma divided by gamma minus 1. So 2 will be remaining as it is. So the final expression is beta optimal, which is optimal pressure ratio, is equals to TR whole to the power of gamma divided by 2 times of gamma minus 1 is the required expression for the maximum specific work output of a ideal Brayton cycle. Okay.